Thank you. concerned our COVID-19 protocol. Other two were allowed to sit by the green and white marker. As a family in the same house, we are sitting together. Other than that, please allow your staff to observe the protocol. Those are the best ones, and they know and follow as much as possible.
Thank you. Okay.
If you want to get the ball closer than you should, you may want to text and drive at the same time. preaching it. replace them. Thanks.
Thank you.
angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord, both of the dead and the living. We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms.
Dear people of God, it is with faith in Jesus Christ that we receive the body of our brother Collis buried. Our brother was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore continue to pray to God, who is the giver of life, and who is our heavenly Father, that he will raise him to perfection. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before this day our brother Collis. We thank you for giving him to us, his family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us for mourning. Give us faith to see in death the gain of eternal life, so that in great confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your most gracious call we are reunited with those who long to go, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Rest eternal, grant unto him, O Lord. Lord, and the souls of all the faithful departed, to the tender mercies of God, rest in peace and guidance in glory.
My dear friends, as I reflect on the events among all, I hope to be here for the beginning of the service of Christian marriage. She wasn't in the meeting, she was today, but she's offered her apologies. She shall be ready to be here. She's in the leadership called the back part of the a church. So the second day, because we were meeting rather the protocol in mind that we've got word from her. I say that as I am ready at this point in time.
Within 228, immortal, invisible, God only wise.
Thank you. us, we must make our lives alive and pardon behind us footprints of the sands of time. Brothers, sisters, we are gathered here in this hallowed place of worship to give thanks and praise to Almighty God for the life and work of your dearly departed brother, who always quoted the psalmist. He says, "How good and holy life it is for all that live like brothers, where God confers his blessing, everlasting life." Collis Earl Blackman was born on November 3rd, 1939, to shopkeeper parents, Pierce and Egan Blackman of Earl's Fort Pilgrim Road Church. He was the first of seven children. His siblings are Willem, who preceded him, Basil, Lennox, Pearson, Trevor, and myself, Ryan. He attended Providence Boys and then Boys Foundation School, where he displayed a sharp intellect and excelled in academics, athletics, and football. He became head boy, and on leaving school, he returned to church at his alma mater. He studied history and economics at the University of West Indies, and graduated first class honors. While at Monaghan, he made the football and athletics team. The story is told about his sojourn to Cuba with the athletic team, and he wrote home telling us of his prowess on the track, boldly proclaimed that he had placed third in the race and won a bronze medal. Everyone was elated until further down the ladder, being an honest chap, he revealed that there were only three people in the race. On his return from university, he gained employment with the government of Barbados, made his holy position of professor at Duff Business College before moving to the Barbados Manufacturers Association. Then joined the Barbados Electronics Confederation as assistant director and subsequently became executive director. In no time, it was time for him to become his own boss. He formed the Blackman Corporation and soon became one of the most sought after human resources and industrial relations consultants in the Caribbean. With regard to his expertise in industrial relations, Bobby Morris attested the hidden exchanges they were had during negotiations and how gracious he would be as either a victor or a vanquished, a man who walked placidly amid the noise of confusion while remembering what peace there had been in silence. Later in life, he obtained an LLB from the UK campus, specializing in labor law. He was an advocate, but a fact surgeon. Covering number of topics, lots of jokes, and numerous anecdotes from these books were used in many speeches, which he gave praiseworthy life. In the 2012 Queen's Birthday Honours, he was made a member of the Order of the British Empire for services to labor relations. He was also named an expert in the field of labor relations by the International Labor Organization. Collis often forgot his own happiness by creating a little happiness for others. Because, as he used to say, when you are good to others, you are best to yourself. As part of his community work, Paul was a member of JC's and Toastmasters. He also joined the Divine Cell, but that is another chapter. He eventually served as president of each one. I remember him playing down the roads as if it was yesterday, with people in super last year, all Paris, for remarkable players. And he, after trashing his opponents, boldly proclaimed that Garasolas was still a brain, yes, it's lady of boxing, the lady of the ball, and caused Batman Donald State. He and his heart-felt were brave enough to go to Grenada in October 1982. have always been resident descendants, nieces, nephews, and other relatives, but he was always ready to help, and that help was urgent in need. He loved his brothers. Yes, he did love his brothers, and had a special love for his sister. Many times when he visited, he might be home without his brother, mere others. He had a penchant for giving gifts to every household at Christmas. One Christmas, my youngest son gave us a step for less than a day
with the long death of all,
the name of God, Mr. and Mrs. Claus, because of their matching souvenir and gifts to hand. This year, Claus is working on different day. As young as growing up, he was a disciplinarian and he was committed to excellent ideas.
Here I borrow two words from Collis, I digress.
I remember him black money in soap and water, chasing into a surrounding shopping house, armed with a piece of poker and branch, catching him and administering some warm lashes to his dog's so, throat. To discipline him for some ugly activity which he called his dog was inappropriate. Today, your third brother's mission, a testament to the result of a disciplined foundation and strategic planning. I too was not scared of disciplinary action. Collis was a man who walked with things and did not move the common touch. He could take triumph and disaster in the same breath. He was a gentleman who would use some choice words if he thought it necessary, as he rode with his honesty and humility. But in an instant, he would offer a helping hand to the mortal woman, who was just fierce with his patriotic, vocal soul. Now, here was a man who would negotiate with almost every religion to a human individual, but he could not negotiate a note or a melody. For this is an awesome. He had to fear his songs. If it could help somebody with God's head, he used to. I would always love you. And he was always trying to serve you. Once one visit, Collis was thus to be singing, I would always love you. And he didn't sit up straight. But they asked him what he was obsessed with me, so that the neighbors would not think I was beating him and calling Collis. All he wanted to get to our neighbor's dogs were barking on top. As I say, he would never sing, but the not would have told me that he was also a very hard note and wrote the first solo radio in Dark and Dash, which was geared on our next radio. He also wrote the Baby Column in the newspaper. Almost 5 years ago, all seven started the decline, the major and Alzheimer's, working overtime, or taking over. In those early days, his deep love for his family service. And he would call me and ask to tell him not to worry. I was always seen. He gave me messages for dad and for Jessica. He took up residency at the Ocean View Nursing Home, where Linda and her team of American workers took exceptional care of him. We visited him every Sunday, and he was always skinny and well dressed, as if going on a day of poetry or anything. Sometimes he speaks only Latin or Greek or French, or sometimes the language unknown to us. Life is never another need, never another problem, never another hurtful moment, but never forget that we have a loving, compassionate, and forgiving Father, for God who protects us, guides us, and continues to help us attain a meaningful life. Rest in peace, dearest brother. I shall miss you. I will miss you, Collis. We will miss you. May the angels and saints keep you safe at home with the animal. Well done, my brother, sir. Rest in peace, my brother, and my eyes grow.
walked across the campus of the meeting to Mayor and saw a well-dressed young man walking to rescue. That broad smile, which turned everyone to men, and I instantly recognized him as Collis. He kept in touch, and whenever I visited, he made a point of taking me. He was a brilliant conversationalist with a terrific sense of humor, and the time he discussed always passed me. I was not surprised that he chose a career in industrial relations, where he endeavored to right the wrongs of injustice in the workplace and to be an advocate for workers who had difficulty having their voices heard. He also reached the wider community by writing a column in the weekly advocate newspaper, which was intellectual and educational. You will be remembered for not allowing yourself to stray from issues being discussed, but cleverly introduce another one after which you can interject the recent events, but I digress. The history newsroom, this became history used by those who write this argument. I find myself quoting those words when telling stories to those who listen. I treasure the memories and will lovingly remember them. Until we meet again, may you rest in peace. My deepest sympathy to all the families. His loving cousin, Elaine Harden.
You will now have the first slide of the reading by Ellen. Thank you.
verses 2 to 7. I saw the Holy City, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "See, the home of God, the among mortals,
grandfather, and so all the God's children at 7 years and 47 and 87 and 97. Because as God sees the making a bouquet for his children, and transition comes, death occurs. She's a horrible thing. He's a dreadful thing. It's a nasty thing. Death. The Bible says, death is an enemy. Or death very close to thee. Or grave is over to thee. No man ever said it here. But of all since then, death has no more dominion over. Death cannot kill us. He's not the last sin. The same spirit goes on to say, thanks be to God who gives the victory in Jesus Christ our Lord. So then it is not the end, but the transition is rather painful. And to where we are going, no one has gone before to come back and say. And that perplexes the biblical writers of the second formula. When they were in the wilderness, and when they reached the promised land, they couldn't quite understand what it was. And they said it was a land flowing with milk and honey. And if I know this facetious, I suspect that the Israelites in that day and age were not actors and followers, and the daughter of the middle of the men. But that has it been. And John the Seer, the Revelation, that is the streets were paved with gold. Imagine something like that. And I've used this illustration before. Let me see. 12 bathrooms, 13 bedrooms or 14 bedrooms, a day of bed, or a Mercedes Benz, and anything like that. And blessings yet to come. Paul says, but I don't have seen, ears have not heard, the things prepared for those who love God. So on the other side of what she has left us, what he has left us, what it has left us, better things are prepared for us as a people of God. So we aim for excellence. We reach out for other people. And you know as well, she appears. You see, death is never really unexpected. There are some things in life you should expect. One with taxes, and the other one with death. And in the secular world, you're going to expect, I suspect, if you walk across the cities, if you're in the business of selling, shopkeeper, as we said, a supermarket, canteen food, a petrol station, as well as a petrol in your vehicle, or diesel in your vehicle, then you need the food director if you die. It's such a thing in life. So they're really unexpected. But however, a parish is there. Notice that the cat, dog, chasing very round with the tail. The food will not go down. The dog is there and the person is not there. They don't go ahead and no run for this. The last enemy to be strong. If it comes suddenly, we leave. We don't get back home. We go sleep. And you wake up dead, but I'm not suddenly just like that. But even as it did, still know God cares, God loves everyone. So we measure not our worth by the number of years. We measure them all from the beginning to the end. And what happens in between there, the important thing. When we start, doesn't matter. When we end, doesn't matter what happens in between. Not like that salt that is set before it was dashed or something so, but it dashed in between the important thing in your life and in my life. Very, very important indeed. So then we say farewell to our departed. No matter the age, we will cry and we will lament. Jesus wept at the friend. The devil was friend, Lazarus. And in the original language, his spirit moved within very quickly in him, so to speak. And if the perfect human being could do that, we too begin to act that way. But says St. Paul, we do not sorrow as those who have gone. And regardless of the length of age, we still thank God for him, but we want him to be with us a little longer. I do not know.
He's still in the business of saving sinners. He's not someone who said, and you die, you come out again. No, no. I do not seek to get rest, but when I do sin, I get his words. And I offer them to you, if you do not have that personal relationship with you. I'm not talking about my mother, or my father, or my sister. I'm not talking about knowing Jesus the Christ. I'm talking about Man, we do acknowledge your presence and we're glad to have you. And I can't identify everyone in this day and age of first call. But I find it really possible to share with you. We share with you. We don't want to offer sympathy, but empathy as well. Continue to pray for those who are in need. May God of all hope and comfort and consolation will uphold them and surround them with everlasting arms and with mercy. For them, farewell. And we will believe that as a child of God, we will be able to say to you, well done, good and faithful. Rest the joy of that unto the table of the Lord. And so, Lord, all souls will be able to the mercy of God. Rest in peace.
Please stand.
Thank you.
giving light to those who stand in darkness.
Therefore, as dead to sin and alive to God in Jesus Christ our Lord. Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who sleep. For as by man came death, by man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ shall all be made alive. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Come in the restaurant. Anybody be careful?
Lord, now lettest thy servant depart in peace, according to thy word. For my eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles and to be the glory of thy people Israel. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forevermore.
My friends in Jesus Christ, if it's all possible, and we can practice in some instances a bit of social distances, it'd be very much appreciated. Remember, those in this household, they can stay together, the same house, not necessarily family members from others. Where possible, we would appreciate it. And we thank you very much in advance.
Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart, therefore, is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. Man born of a woman has but a short time to live. Like a flower, he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow, he flees and never stays. In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can we turn for help but to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins? Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you.
Ensure our uncertain hope of resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. We commend to Almighty God our brother Collis Earl, and we commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you in infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved Son shall come again in judgment, both this our brother Collis Earl and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, with whom still live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants who, having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved the spirit of faith, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord. May he rest in peace. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the tender mercies of God, rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen.
The hymn 232, My God, How Wonderful Thou Art.
From one generation to another. Before the mountains were brought forth, or the land and the earth were born, from age to age you are God. You turn us back to the dust and say, go back, O child of earth. For 1,000 years in your sight are like yesterday, when it is past, like a watch in the night. You sweep us away like a dream. We fade away suddenly like the grass. In the morning it is green and flourishes. In the evening it is dried up and withered. For we consume away in your displeasure. We are afraid because of your wrathful indignation. Our iniquities you set before you, and our secret sins in the light of your countenance. When you are angry, all our days are gone. We bring our years to an end like a sigh. The span of our life is 70 years, perhaps in strength even 80. Yet the sum of them is but labor and sorrow. For they pass away quickly, and we are gone. Who regards the power of your wrath? Who rightly fears your indignation? So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts to wisdom. Return, O Lord, how long will you tarry? Be gracious to your servants. Satisfied by your loving kindness in the morning, so shall we rejoice and be glad all the days of our life. Make us glad by the measure of the days you afflicted us and the years in which we suffered adversity. Show your servants your works and your splendor to your children. May the graciousness of the Lord our God be upon us. Prosper the work of our hands. Prosper our handiwork.
Hymn 143. Praise to the holiest in the height.
I forget I wasn't given a list of those who might have been able to attend. I acknowledge only the first covering. I think I'm correct.
Commissioner of Police, I acknowledge his presence as well. I suspect there would have been others that would have been given those who might have been able to attend. And then in this age, day and age, our face coverings, they tend to cover quite a lot. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear though the earth be moved, and though the mountains be toppled into the depths of the sea, those waters rage and foam, and though the mountains tremble at its tumult. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. There is a river that through streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be overthrown. God shall help her at the day of break, the break of day. The nations make much ado, and the kingdoms are shaken. God has spoken, the earth shall melt away. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come now and look upon the works of the Lord. What awesome thing he has done on the earth. It is he who makes wars to cease in all the world. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear and burns the shield with his fire. Be still and know then that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. The astronaut is going to take a bit of time for the solid technicians to fully cover before the, because the earth is wet. I ask you please to note, when it comes to the laying of the wreaths, the floor children, please listen extremely carefully. The Parish Church of Christ Church does not, nor does the funeral home of Clyde Jones, accepts any responsibility if perchance, you refuse the assistance in laying a floral wreath. Those of the funeral home, they will extend their hand, and please be kind enough to be guided by them. If you refuse, you will accept no responsibility here at Christ Church, and I suspect the funeral home will do the same. Why should I say something like that? Because we've had instances before where people in their floral tributes have sought to put the blame upon us because of a slight fall and such like. So I have to clear myself, and at my old age of 75, I really don't have money to pay out. I'm not paying out money for anybody like that. Sorry to be like hearted at this day, but when the time does come, please, I beg you again, take your time. I can step all of your hair and wait for you. I only have to go home and get my supper. I can step all of your hair and wait, but take your time, please, please, please. I thank you.
Jesus, my shepherd, brother, friend, my prophet, priest, and king, my Lord, my life, my way, my end, accept the praise I bring. The hymn, How Sweet the Name of Jesus, sounds in a believer's ear.
Oh,
Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, the maker and redeemer of all humankind, grant us with your servant, Collis Earl, and all the faithful departed, the sure benefit of your Son's saving passion and glorious resurrection, that in the last day when you gather up all things in Christ, we may with them enjoy the fullness of your promises through Jesus Christ, O Lord. Rest eternal grant unto him, O Lord. The souls of the faithful departed through the tender mercy of God, rest in peace. We're going to have the floral tributes laid in a moment. Once again, we thank you very much for your presence. Much appreciated. We thank you very much for your reverence as well. Get home safely. And remember to observe all of the COVID-19 regulations as far as you possibly can. I thank you for trying to listen and obey as far as your distancing and such like would be concerned. Just give the soil technicians a moment, and then we'll have the closing hymn, during which the floral tributes will be laid. And have a restful and a peaceful night. Have wonderful dreams. I can't say it's a dream about you, about me, lest I frighten you, but nonetheless, have good dreams. We're now ready for the floral tributes to be laid. They will be laid during the singing of the hymn as is announced. If necessary, according to the number of tributes to be laid, we'll sing over the hymn. The hymn is now announced.
384. Praise to the Lord, the Almighty.
Holy, holy, Lord God,
else is a French priest? Grandchildren? Children? What else are the two? Over unto the tribute I led, praise to the Lord your Almighty.
Once again, thanks very, very much. Get home safely. May St. Christopher, the patron of land travelers, be with you. May our Blessed Mother Mary, most holy, be with you. May our guardian angels and saints surround you. May you wake up to a new day, a wonderful week, and all of the best for you. For members of the choir, go in peace and serve the Lord.
Amen.
Thank you very, very much indeed.
Thank you.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
Thank you.